So this voyage is a really critical first step in setting up the next 30 years of the RSV Nuyina. We have been delivered an immensely capable ship, and now we have to learn how to use it, learn how to operate it in this environment, and that's the challenge that's before us. But I think on this voyage we're making a really solid start. One of the significant things about RSV Nuyina is that she's an icebreaker, and that allows us to get into areas that no other ship can do. So it's really important for Australia to have a capability to get scientists into the ice zone so that we can uncover the secrets of this region.
I would say that that particular fuel is the lifeblood of the station. You think about everything that we do to power the station. So you think about what keeps you warm, what feeds you, the lighting, what heats the water when you have a shower. There's, you know, the diesel runs everything.
So far we're going really well. The weather's playing ball with us today, the winds are low, the ship's working well as it should, the lines are going well, and the refuelling is going to schedule, which is awesome.
We'll head to 2,600 metres.
The multibeam uses sound to map the seabed, so it sends out a fan of sound underneath the ship, and then we measure how long it takes for that sound to bounce off the seafloor to give us an image of the shape of the seabed.
We switched on the filter table and very quickly an Antarctic krill came out, shortly followed thereafter by an absolute swarm of krill which just launched down into our collection table, and we, in a matter of 5 minutes, had about 400 krill swimming in buckets next to us. Absolutely amazing.
A lot of these animals will come all the way back to AAD head office in Kingston. We've got an aquarium facility out the back there where we're making space for these animals as we speak. And they'll be divided up into appropriate tanks, hopefully ready for students and researchers to come and work with them.
So a moon pool, which is essentially a hole in the middle of the ship, allows us to lower scientific equipment through the vessel instead of out the side. And this is really important on an icebreaker, where a lot of the time we're completely surrounded by ice. It was largely successful. We tested our nerve, we got down there, all the systems worked.
NUTS is Nuyina Underwater Towed Termination System. It lets us send 1 kilowatt of power down to underwater systems, and we can use the fiber optic lines in the tow cable to get way more data up the cable than what was possible in the past.
So the data is collected from a really wide range of sensors. So we have meteorological instruments, seabed mapping sensors, we have oceanographic instruments. So we have these broad range of sensors that all feed into collecting data aboard the ship.
Well, this is an opportunity to actually test out the tasks that the ship was designed to do. And actually, I've been surprised at how easy some of the tasks have been. There's been a lot of preparation and a lot of planning go into them, and there's been practice at various tasks doing this and that, but this is the first time that we've done all of those things together in concert.
The ship is equipped with a large array of very advanced and complicated scientific systems, and it will take us many years to get to grips with those systems, but I think we've made a very solid start on this voyage.